In this video, I'll take you through the steps of simplifying a radical like this, the square root of 180, and putting it in what's called simple radical form. The first thing that's good to check using a calculator or anything else is just to see if 180 is a perfect square, meaning that we can take the square root of it and get a nice whole number as an answer. In this instance, it isn't. So what we want to do is break 180 up into its prime factors, meaning the small prime numbers that multiply together to make up 180. That gives us the building blocks that really create or make up the number, and from there we can see what we can simplify out of the radical. So first up, let's take a look at the number 180. There are a lot of different ways to break a number up into prime factors. Here I'm going to use a tree diagram. Really all I need to do first is come up with two numbers that multiply to 180. The first two I think of are 18 and 10. Neither of these are prime numbers, so I'm going to see what breaks how these break up, meaning what numbers will multiply to create them. 18 is going to be 2 times 9. Now 2 is a prime number, which means it's going to be one of the numbers we'll multiply together to create this number to make up 180. 9 is not prime, it's in fact 3 times 3. So thus far I know 2, 3, and 3 are prime factors. Now let's take a look at the 10. 10 is going to be 2 times 5. Both of those are prime, so I'll go ahead and circle those to indicate them. That means that 180, what I have inside my radical right here, can be rewritten as 2 times 2 times 3 times 3 times 5. Just putting them in order from smallest to largest. That's what I've got inside my radical. Now, since this is a square root, you notice there's no number here for the index, so that we assume it is a 2, meaning it's a square root. I want to see if I can take the factors and pair them together, meaning rewrite stuff specifically using 2 as an exponent. When you look here, I have these two 2s I can rewrite as 2 squared. These two 3s being multiplied together, I can rewrite as 3 squared. So I'm going to take this and rewrite it as 2 squared times 3 squared times 5. Again, this is still all, as of right now, inside my square root. Well, according to the properties of square roots, we can take this and break it apart into 3 separate radicals because we're multiplying. You can't do it with addition or subtraction, but you can when you're multiplying. You notice here and here, we are multiplying these things together. They're factors. So I'm going to go ahead and rewrite this first one as the square root of 2 squared, then times the square root of 3 squared, times the square root of 5. Both of these that had 2 as an exponent will simplify. Square root of 2 squared is 2. The square root of 3 squared is 3. Now the square root of 5, 5 is not a perfect square, and there's nothing in there that I can simplify out of my radical, so I'm just going to leave it the square root of 5. If we go ahead and simplify this together, you notice we get 2 times 3, which is 6, root 5. So my original radical, 180, the square root of 180, is also the same as 6 times the square root of 5. And this is what we usually refer to as simple radical form, meaning anything that we can take the square root of perfectly, anything that is a perfect square that multiplies to create 180, we're going to take the square root of and pull it out of the radical so that the stuff that's left, the 5, is as small as possible. That's it.